got from these guys, Nestor, Crafty Master, game one, Pokemon Stadium 2, pretty even looking setup for both characters, really.
I know this is definitely a good stage for Snake. Wolf doesn't really have bad stages,
yeah.
But it's still like, I don't know if this one favors one or the other. Right now, Snake just with his small percent lead, but they're still kind of going each other out at the beginning of the game.
Oh yeah, the only thing that I've learned from fighting really, really good Snakes is certain stages, like, of all things, Dry Plat, platform stages are great for them because they can actually just mine the entire battlefield. They have like, crap everywhere, and it's insane to just try and get down. Util setup. Crafty takes the first stock.
That's just straight up on Wolf at 90, and he just dies.
Absolutely.
You cannot land on a lot of Snakes. Definitely fish for that move. You can't land directly on him when you're at kill percent.
Oh yeah, Util was his best move in, like, Brawl. Because Util is just super range, super kill power. It's an exceptional attack.
I would have said that Snake had the best upshield until Steve came out, so...
Oh yeah.
But either way, right now, Nestor looking for this kill.
Oh yeah, trying to get some pressure in there. Not really going for any hard committals. Of course, Snake is at 178. You only just need to sneeze on him and he goes down. But after a few of you are, he's still up.
He takes it.
Alright, good luck. I'll keep commentate here. I got this. Okay. So, Crafty, Nestor. He looks like.
Do you remember how to work the scoreboard and all that?
You'll have to show me.
Alright, so it's this cannibal. In case it ever disappears, it's just a cannibal icon and then. You know, somebody goes up, just plus one, and then update.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Pretty easy.
Yeah, thank you. So we're down on a second stock, 80, 96. We got relatively even. Snake had a slight lead, and of course, you got to consider Snake's also a heavy character. So even if they're both at match percent, Snake's, you never want to just let him just live. Man, those bears are freaking nasty. If he's trying to go over reflect, would have been a good option, but he didn't need to use it. But trying to roll and overcommit, Crafty punishes the overcommitted roll, taking the second stock, holds the advantage. Oh, sweet spot. Wolf Flash was beautiful. Okay, so, liking what I see here, you smash out of shield, definitely not over. Don't roll out Nestor yet. Notice that Nestor is being quite aggressive in his attempt to get back in. Crafty taking advantage. Crafty doing his best to continue forcing the approach, going for outer shield punishes, and still going for some hard committals. Surprisingly going for an aggressive option like a dash attack, even though he's at 159. He's not trying to just play a pure bait and punish. He's actually going in. Nestor struggling to get the kill, trying to go for the overcommit. We use F smash, gets killed under... Round 100 off that util. Crafty Master takes game one. Get your perspective, chat. Who wins the matchup overall? Wolf or Snake? Put it in the comments. I'd like to see it. Morris personally felt it's even.
Who's that? 1-0 Nestor?
Crafty won.
Crafty,
yeah. Snake won. We are game two. We are back to Stadium 2. Neutral stage. Once again, I feel it benefits them both relatively evenly. It just depends on who. Better at the matchup, he's gonna win overall, just the better player. Out of shield grab, going for the combo. Unless we're getting a little press happy there. Snake gets out of his grasp, countering into a grab of his own. I can definitely feel the pressure from Nestor's play. I notice he is starting to press a lot. Crafty playing a little bit of a keep away, but I know yet he's gonna go for the approach. He's gonna go for the aggressive option. There's almost a double percent difference here. Nestor on a slight lead, but a disadvantage right now. Anything can still happen. Oh my god, that would have been a perfect time for a reflect. Looks like we missed entirely. So, 94, 115, blown up by a grenade. Zone grenade. No util, only enough tilt. going for the Nikita bait. Even if he misses the Nikita, he still holds stage control. But he lets Nestor slip, takes the F tilt. Nestor has the first stock advantage. So both players are starting to get a little press happy here. A little mash happy, throwing out lots of attacks.
Let me get Sakana and Edmund on station 14. Sakana and Edmund on station 14.
All of these are going relatively unchecked. There's a lot of touch and go in this particular game. I notice neither one is really committing to the option here. Nestor knows that he is in kill percent. Crafty also aware of where one or two setups could take a stock as well. Even though Snake is quite heavy, Wolf can steal the stock at this percent with an F smash near the ledge. So both of them playing a very dangerous game.
11 and King's Aid on station 12. 11 and King's Aid on station 12.
He looked like he got away. Crafty barely clipping him with the U-tilt, taking this first stock. Use the Master Shadow Shield, not gonna kill. City 2 has a pretty even, it's not like huge top blast zone like Battlefield. Wolf's Wii U Smash is not like, I don't think it's as powerful as Snake's U-tilt, so it's still gonna take a little bit more to middle from Wolf, but he has already eaten 100 damage in just a few seconds. That being said,
Dark Blue, Forte, Station 4. Dark Blue and Forte on Station 4.
Beautiful pair. What I was trying to say was the game plan for Wolf, U Smash out of shield usually works around 130-ish, maybe a little bit later for Snake. The best thing that a Wolf can generally do in any matchup, but especially against one like Snake that lives forever, going for those early kills. Your F smashes, G smashes, edge guards, bears. Snake takes the stock, Crafty Master puts it to an even stock with an 85% deficit. He's already nailing 25% on Wolf. Both of them playing a very even, neutral game. Not going for any risky edge guards, not trying to get the early kill. Both of them playing respectfully against one another's offense. Both of them still also playing a very press-heavy game. But again, the momentum doesn't really shift from the center.
Zombie and Goofy Guy on station one. Zombie and Goofy Guy.
Neither one
on
wants to commit
one.
To anything too risky, and both of them are playing on borrowed time here. Oh my god, the C4, it did not kill either.
Steven.
Both over 100%. Okay. Nestor is, again, playing a very dangerous game, but gets the U Smash hooks. Crafty, the way Crafty can hook with his U tilt, taking the second game.
Aiden Lorax on station 7.
Winner take all and winners here. Hollow Bastion. Snake gets a single platform to mine and mix up. The Wolf also has free reign of neutral, range of neutral anyway. So again, I'd say it's a pretty even kill stage right here. We're already starting with the advantage. Notice Nestor not committing fully to the zoning. And
let me get Fallen and AP Slayer on station 5.
Going
Fallen
in for the dash.
AP Slayer on station 5.
Going in for a ton of unsafe offense. Very risky play here. He knows one dash attack, one setup from Snake can definitely teeter him in the opposite direction. As we see here, bears for days. 77-87, so relatively even game right now. Both of them now trying to play some projectiles, but also going in with a little bit of a mix-up. And notice when they both start getting closer to kill percent, they both definitely play more respectful of each other, more zoning, more centered stage. So right now, Nestor has a slight advantage. Going for some very high risk bears. one drop off that Snake's Rage U-Tilt might have actually taken that stock. Oh my god, very close beast match. Woo! Alright, clutch time. Who's gonna get it first?
Jacob 30, Hydrangea, Station 10.
Good lord. Honestly, I'm loving the tenseness of this. Even though he's got a 50% advantage. Nestor is playing a hard time, but takes the first stock. U-Smash catching landings on both sides. One of the best landing catchers in the game. Got to respect Wolf's advantage state and not land so close. You land so close, he's got multiple options to take you out. So now Crafty Master has the burden of trying to approach, knocking the sweet sour spot of U-Tilt, not killing Wolf as a result. He has the burden of both having to approach and successfully manages the bear on the corner, taking the first stock on his opponent. So on one hand, F-Jump. On the other hand, explosives. Hitting grenades on shield, definitely a surefire way to get yourself punished for trying to put pressure on the opponent.
Station 6, player 1, hard to play. Station 6, player 1, and hard to play.
A little bit of a back and forth here. Crafty holding position there, letting Nestor slip once again into neutral. Now we are once again playing with toys, blasters, grenades, zoning in, pummeling and grab and getting grenaded, blowing both of them up. At almost literally even percents, this has been a very even set. Both players going with a very similar game plan. A relatively familiar close range game for Wolf and the Snake going in. When they realize, you know, hey, I'm not going to zone you out, they go in. Both with solid approach tools, in spite of otherwise being very solid zoners. Alright. Nestor on. Leonard's stock. Crafty refusing to take any chances. Going for the RPG. Blocked and out of shield D smash. We are both on winner's stock here.
Steven Wolf and Wally on station 2. Steven Wolf and Wally on station 2.
Nestor knows he needs to rack up some damage and make something happen, but at this point, oh wow, Crafty is now on the disadvantage. 32, 61%. Believe it or not, Crafty is only a couple of percents away from getting an F smash range. Though at the same time, Crafty could also just go for edge guards. He can go for an RPG of his own. F smashes on both ends are both incredibly powerful.
Jacob 30 here.
Whoever gets the setup here.
They've
been keeping it close. Bear, but sour spotted. Bear is not going to kill yet. Not at that percent. Going for the F smash. The F smash is unchecked. Nestor actually getting some more advantages.
Sean and Sid on station 3. Sean and Sid on station 3.
Oh, reliable. Snake F-Tilt, still one of the best in the game. Going for the thing, Nestor wisely not trying to challenge it. We're back to pretty much where we've been the entire time to set both players, even keel. One C4, one U-Tilt. And we've got the B-Throw. Nestor takes game two. Honestly, this is a wonderful way to open up for
Rango and Westbaum on station 9. Rango and Westbaum on station 9.
Is that game 2 or game 3?
That was game 3.